Hello, my name is Sierra Barnes, and I'm a digital solution consultant with ServiceNow, specializing in strategic portfolio management. Today, I'll go over the new features for our Utah release, introducing our new strategic planning workspace. Before I get to that information, with our safe harbor notice, I want to inform you that this presentation may contain forward-looking statements that reflect the current beliefs of ServiceNow and are based on any current information. So these forward-looking statements should not be relied upon in making purchasing decisions. Our strategic planning workspace, formerly known as the Alignment Planner Workspace that comes with a pro license, provides an integrated end-to-end planning experience that aligns strategy to execution by enabling business leaders to define and track goals across the organization, gather, review, and prioritize work that aligns with the strategy and commit to them once they're on a roadmap, all on a single platform. Strategic planning's flexible design supports agile, hybrid, and waterfall planning methodologies and allows planners to visualize, manage, and share their portfolio plans. The new features in this release provides more configuration options that allows planners to have more control over how they manage their work. These new features include three lenses that offer flexible options for customers to plan and track their work in an organization, five configurable custom planning item tables, and a configurable Kanban board that visually maps and progresses planning items for lean portfolio management. The first new lens is the project portfolio lens, which is designed to enable customers who are already using the portfolio tables to take advantage of the lens functionality. By default, this lens groups planning items like demands and projects into portfolios. Next is a value stream lens, which enables you to plan, prioritize, and roadmap work as it aligns to a value stream. This basic lens structure was designed with app dev value streams in mind and breaks down value streams into products and then epics. The final new lens is the goal lens, which enables you to create goal-driven portfolio plans. And this lens simply displays all goals and sub-goals. And here's a layout of the six lenses included in the strategic planning workspace, along with their out-of-box configuration. In our workspace, you'll be able to adjust any existing lens or configure a new lens with up to six levels of planning. After creating your lenses, you can use those lenses to view all relevant work on the prioritization tab. So within our planning board, we have three different views. The first is the list view, which is what you're used to seeing. The next is the hierarchy view, like the one shown here. And then the third is the Kanban view, which I'll cover shortly. You can select the view using the buttons that appear in the upper right corner. And by using the cog on the right, you can configure which columns are displayed on the grid. And you also have the option to add any columns related to planning items. The bars on the timeline view are color-coded based on its planning state, which can be dragged and dropped to change the dates. Then you'll be able to display either the grid or the timeline view, or both if you prefer, as we see here. Each portfolio has a default lens type, but our customers can also use the lens selector to temporarily see work from a different perspective in order to better understand the roll-up of work at every level. By clicking on the ellipses next to any of the planning items, you'll open them in a new tab, and any work items that are not aligned to the lens entities will be grouped together at the bottom of the grid. The next new prioritization view is a configurable Kanban board. Now, this Kanban board supports lean portfolio management and helps portfolio managers visualize and quickly adjust planning items. The horizontal swim lanes and vertical lanes are configurable, and planners can drag and drop the cards in the Kanban to move them to a different lane as shown here. And in order to avoid any accidental changes when dragging and dropping, the priority rank cannot be changed within this Kanban view. Last but not least, let's review our custom planning item tables. These five custom tables are partially pre-configured and are granted in addition to the five custom tables that come with the SPM professional license. So now you will need to use up your custom table allotment in order to include custom planning item types in your lenses. And most of the setup work, including extending the planning item table, has already been completed, as you can see here. And these custom planning item tables are not intended to be used as a level within a lens structure. To start using the custom planning item tables, users will first need to relabel the table. Then, in order for them to be used as a planning item in a lens, you'll need to add them to the value field in the planning item type allow list as shown here. Thank you so much for watching. That concludes the overview of our new strategic planning workspace for SPM. To learn more about strategic portfolio management, please visit our website at servicenow.com or contact your account team.